Right now, the search continues for the killer of a Sacramento County Sheriff's deputy, and we're learning more about the man killed in the line of duty. His name is Vu Nguyen. He was 37 years old and worked for the Sacramento Sheriff's Department for 7 years. He'd been part of the gang task force since April.
We have live team coverage tonight. Live Copter 3 HD is over the scene, and we have two reports from the ground, beginning with KCRA 3's Leticia Ardaz live from the scene of the shooting. What's the latest there, Leticia?
Well, Dave, there is still a lot of activity here on 42nd Avenue. As a matter of fact, the chopper is still overhead. Take a look, and you can see the crime scene here where the deputy was shot and killed earlier today. Right now, officers are still searching for the gunman. Earlier, there were some 400 to 500 officers on scene, but with nobody in custody, neighbors here remain on edge. It's with a heavy heart that hundreds of men and women in uniform came together to search for the man who killed one of their own. One officer on scene says this is such a heinous crime that everyone that wears a badge wanted to get involved. Just after 2 p.m., two gang officers with the Sacramento County Sheriff's Department went into this neighborhood near 37th Street and 42nd Avenue in South Sacramento. They separated during a short foot pursuit. Moments later, one of the deputies heard gunshots and found his partner with a gunshot to his neck. You could hear the sheriff's deputies from the air pleading with the gunman in hiding to turn himself in, saying the dog will always find you, avoid a painful dog bite. The manhunt shut down several streets for miles, and schools and businesses went on lockdown.
We just wanted to stay inside and make ourselves safe.
It's scary.
Families near the crime scene were told to stay indoors.
My mom's scared half to death. They keep knocking on the door, and she's panicked.
As soon as they clear everything, they'll let me come home.
James Woolsey lives on 37th Street. He couldn't get to his wife for nearly 5 hours. He was terrified the man who killed the deputy could get near his home.
Well, if anything happens to my wife, I mean, he'll pay.
And back here live, just in the last couple of minutes, we've seen many more patrol cars pulling up to 42nd Avenue. We're not sure exactly what is going on, but there's definitely a lot of activity right now. We're going to be out here monitoring the situation and bring you the very latest if any developments become available. Reporting live in South Sacramento, Leticia Ordaz, KCRA 3 reports.
All right, Leticia, and earlier this evening, Sacramento County Sheriff John McGinnis speaking out about this cop killer.
He's described him as a serious threat to the community.
This is an individual who has graphically demonstrated his willingness to be violent, in this case with a law enforcement officer. He poses very much as a threat to the safety of anybody who may be near him. So please stay indoors. Don't put yourself in harm's way. If you see anything suspicious, certainly somebody matching this physical description, please contact us right away.
The gunman is described as a dark-complected Asian man between the ages of 18 and 20 years old, about 5'4", weighing between 130 and 140 pounds. He was last seen wearing a green puffy camouflage jacket. If you have any information about this case, you're urged to call one of the two hotline numbers that have been set up. Those numbers are 916-874-6500 and 800-471-1700. And for the Sacramento County Sheriff's Department tonight, this is a death in the tight brotherhood of police officers.
A difficult time. Our live team coverage continues now with more on Deputy Vu Nguyen. From KCRA 3's Damani Lewis, who is live at the sheriff's headquarters. Damani.
Edie and Dave, we are learning more information about Detective Vu Nguyen. Just 8 months ago, he married his wife. This evening, unfortunately, his family is preparing for his funeral.
He ran towards it, putting himself in harm's way in the interest of serving the community and protecting the community, and unfortunately, he paid the ultimate price.
Sheriff John McGinnis and the entire Sacramento County Sheriff's Department is now in mourning after a fellow deputy, 37-year-old Detective Vu Nguyen, was shot and killed Wednesday afternoon.
This was his calling. This is what he did. It's a job that certainly not everybody is cut out for.
Investigators say Nguyen was a 7-year veteran. He was shot at least once in the neck and rushed to UC Davis Medical Center. Within the hour of being shot, more than a dozen police officers and sheriff's deputies rushed to the hospital to show support. He was listed in critical condition and taken into surgery.
And in spite of the efforts to revive him and save him, he has succumbed to his injuries and unfortunately suffered another loss.
Authorities say Nguyen has been a part of the gang unit since April of this year. It was in that same month Nguyen married his wife. Back in 2003, we spoke with Detective Nguyen as he investigated a double homicide. During that interview, he served as a translator, urging people to come forward.
That's definitely what we're hoping the case will be, is that people would be more willing to speak or more comfortable speaking if they know something about this crime.
Detective Nguyen is the 16th person killed in the line of duty for the Sacramento County Sheriff's Department. We're live in Sacramento. Damani Lewis, KCRA 3 reports.
And throughout the evening, live coverage of Free HD providing the aerial coverage of this massive police presence.
Dan Shively is still covering the search. So, Dan, what does the search look like from your vantage point right now?
Well, right now we're looking down at the Star helicopter, the Sacramento Sheriff's helicopter, and they are looking at a large field out behind St. Patrick's School. They're using their powerful searchlight, and they're also looking at it with an infrared camera as well, looking for any heat sources that may be down there. They can see in the complete darkness. Their camera will pick up images based on heat and not on light. So that's one of the activities going on right now here. You can see the helicopter there. Still a huge presence down here. All the roads that were closed, the main roads at least, Martin Luther King Boulevard and Franklin Boulevard, they're both open to traffic now. There are selective residential streets around 37th Street and 41st Avenue that are still closed periodically. Police are on the scene. They're checking out some backyards, and they are stopping people periodically in cars through the area. So the presence and the search still going strong down here. Back to you.
All right, Dan, we have ongoing coverage of this story and our website at kcra.com. You can click on the top stories and you'll find the video of today's news conference, our team coverage reports from the scene, and a link to an officer memorial website, which includes more information on past Sacramento County Sheriff's deputies who died in the line of duty.